بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأولين والآخرين وخاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين وأشرف السفراء المقربين المعروف في أعلى السماوات بأحمد وعلى وجه الأراضين بأبي القاسم محمد. وعلى أهل بيتي الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين المنتجبين الغر الميامين ولا سيما حجة الله في الأراضين وقائم الهداة المهديين الإمام الحجة المهدي المنتظر عجل الله تعالى فرجه الشريف وأرواحنا لتراب مقدمه الفداء. يقول سيدنا ومولانا سيد الأولين والآخرين الحبيب المصطفى صلى الله عليه وآله: أما ابنتي فاطمة فهي سيدة نساء العالمين من الأولين والآخرين. Our dear Prophet Muhammad al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi says, my daughter Fatima is the lady of the women of the world for those of the first times and for those of the later times. To hasten the holy appearance of Sahib al-Zaman alayhi salam and to be among his supporters and companions, please recite one loud salawat. In this happy, auspicious occasion of the birth of the lady of the women of the world, the lady of paradise, and the mother of our dear imams, we offer our congratulations to her awaited son, the imam of our time, Al-Hujjatul Mahdi, Ajallahu Farajahu Sharif, and to all the lovers and followers of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam, all over the world. As it is a birthday, Mawlud, Khushhali, and Alhamdulillah, they've decorated with roses and balloons. Inshallah, we start with some lines of poetry, and inshallah, after every line, I need a loud salawat from you, inshallah. Sorry, I don't have a mic, I'll use my throat, inshallah, it'll help me. If you heard the name of Zahra, if you heard the name of Zahra, the lady of light, raise your voice with the loudest, loudest salawat. This was a good one, inshallah. So I'll recite another line. If you heard the name of Zahra, the daughter of Rasul, raise your voice, salli ala Zahra al-Batul. Imagine those happy moments at the house of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alih in such days. How she filled Fatima Zahra alayhi salam that house with happiness. And imagine the happiness of her mother Khadija al-Kubra alayhi salam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alih and Khadija al-Kubra were the happiest ones on the whole earth. As at last this dear lady was the greatest lady on the whole world, was born in this blessed month of Jamada al-Thani. Alhamdulillah, these 2 months, Jamada al-Ula and Jamada al-Thani, are the month of Fatima al-Zahra, months of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. We start in Jamada al-Ula with the occasion of her martyrdom, the first Fatimiyya, and then it goes till we reach to the second Fatimiyya, the second narration of her martyrdom. as if we are in the school of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. We come to the majalis of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. We learn about Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. She is teaching us in these 2 months. These 2 months, Jamad al-Awwal and Jamad al-Thaniya, are the school of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. It starts from the first Fatimiyah. When is the first Fatimiyah? In Jamad al-Awwal. Ahsant Hajji Abu Zainab. May Allah reward you. But in which day? This is the question. You are the lovers of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. You are the Shia of Imam Ali alayhi salam. And this is her...
17.
لا نقص أربعة حجي.
13.
أحسنت. إيه أحسنت حجي. شاطر بالرياضيات حجي الله يحفظكم موفقين إن شاء الله. Yes. 13th of Jamad al-Awwal is the first Fatimiyah. Then it extends for 20 nights till the second Fatimiyah comes. When is the second Fatimiyah? I've just gave you the answer. 30. After 20 nights. Third of Jamad al-Akhir. Ahsan, brother Hussein. May Allah reward you. For his well-being, please recite aloud salawat. It doesn't stop there. It goes till the birthday of Fatima al-Zahra. Till this day, which is? 20th. Of Jamada Athani. All these are the days of Fatima al-Zahra. This is the school of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. We come to her majalis, we learn about her sacrifice for religion, first. About her iman, about her modesty and hijab, about her purity, about her generosity, about her worshipping, about her piety, all these in these 2 blessed months of Jamad al-Ula and Jamad al-Thani. This is the school of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. And today we had a very beautiful hadith. We started our lecture with a very beautiful hadith from the master of prophets, Rasulullah Muhammad al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa alihi. Very beautiful hadith. Who can remind us of that hadith? We've just said this hadith. We started it with you now in this lecture. Who can remind us? Yes, brother Ali.
Fatima is the greatest woman from the beginning to the end.
Ahsant, ahsant. Can you say it in Arabic, please? For his well-being, allow salawat. Any volunteer in Arabic? Well-known hadith, all our life we have said this hadith. Fatima, Sayyidatu. Yes, yes, you know it. Mina, min al-awwalina wal-akhirin. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi says she is the chief of the ladies of the world, this means that she is the leader and she is the guide and she is the role model for all the women of the world, from al-awwaleen till al-akhirin, like from the beginning of creation, from those who were created first till the end of times. And when we have this great role model, min al-awwaleen wal-akhirin, Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, we have this great leadership. When you have leadership, when you examine the notion of leadership, you have two things. First, you have the leader. Then you have the follower. The follower of that leader who consider him a role model and a guide and follow his footsteps. We have Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam as the leader and we have her Shias as followers. And if we accept her alayhi salam as a leader and a role model, we should follow her footsteps in our life. Because she was not only a role model for us, she was a role model for our dear imams. Our Imam Al-Hujja Al-Mahdi Al-Muntadhar Ajallahu Ta'ala Farajahu Al-Sharif says, وَإِنَّ لِي في ابنة رسول الله قدوة حسنة. And those who have Arabic language know this. إن لي في ابنة رسول الله قدوة حسنة. I have in the daughter of Rasulullah a good example, a good role model. Who's saying this? الإمام الحجة المهدي المنتظر عجل الله تعالى فرجه. His role model is فاطمة الزهراء عليه السلام. We have to know on this occasion the greatness of فاطمة الزهراء عليه السلام. Our 11th Imam, الإمام الحسن العسكري عليه السلام says, إنا حجج الله على الخلق. We are the proof of Allah over mankind. We are the authority of Allah over mankind. But when he comes to talk to about فاطمة الزهراء عليه السلام, he says, وأمنا فاطمة حجة الله علينا. But our mother Fatima is the authority of Allah over us, over our infallible imams in that high position فاطمة الزهراء عليه السلام is. When we have حاجات, we do توسل of our dear imams. We go to the majlis of Imam Hussein عليه السلام. We do توسل of Imam Hussein عليه السلام. We go to باب الحوائج الإمام موسى الكاظم عليه السلام. We do توسل by him. But our dear imams, when they were doing توسل, they were doing توسل but by their mother فاطمة الزهراء. Our Imam Muhammad al-Baqir, when he is in severe pain, in severe fever, he will hold the handle of the door and he will cry, Ya Fatima bint Muhammad. He will ask and he'll do tawassul by Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. This is the greatness of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. If you want to know who is Fatima al-Zahra, let's listen to the definition of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about Fatima al-Zahra. In the well-known Hadith al-Kisa, all of us recite Hadith al-Kisa for our hajat, in our majalis, in our houses. Jibreel and the angels ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who are these five under the cloak? The narration of the cloak. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says first, إِنِّي مَا خَلَقْتُ سَمَاءً مَبْنِيَّةً وَلَا أَرْضًا مَدْحِيَّةً وَلَا شَمْسًا مُضِيئَةً وَلَا قَمَرًا مُنِيرًا وَلَا فَلَكًا يَدُورًا ولا بحرا يجري إلا في محبة هؤلاء الخمسة الذين هم تحت الكساء. I have never created a well-built sky, an extended land, a shining sun, a twinkling moon, a flowing ocean, a revolving planet, except for the love of these five who are under the cloak. So Jibreel, all the angels ask, Ya Allah, who are these five? You have created the whole universe for them. So how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defines Ahl Bayt? Not Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. He says, Hum Fatima. They are Fatima and her father. Fatima and her husband. Fatima and her children. He defines Ahlul Bayt by Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. This is the greatness of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. Ahlul Bayt are Fatima and her father and her husband and her children. She is the definition of Ahlul Bayt. She is the connection and she is the connecting point between Prophethood Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alih. I like these feelings of love for Ahl Bayt of you. You always recite salawat. She is the connecting point between Rasulullah, the prophethood, and her husband and children who are the imams, the imama. She's the connecting point between Nubuwa and imam. This is the greatness of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. She's the role model of our dear imams. And when Rasulullah says at the end of the hadith, what does Rasulullah says at the end of the hadith, hadith we just started tonight. من ال ما شاء الله, all of you memorized. من الأولين والآخرين. Like from those who were first and those who were last. When he says that, he is removing all limitations and restrictions of any time, age, place. She is the role model of all mankind at any time, age, place. Fatima al-Zahra alayha salam. In the old times, in these times, and in the coming times, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. So we are tonight here celebrating her birthday, the birthday of Fatima al-Zahra alayha salam. Let's ask ourselves, let's be truthful with ourselves. We are celebrating her birthday. Are we actually following Fatima al-Zahra alayha salam as a role model in our life? Let's have a moment of truthfulness with ourselves and stop with ourselves in this night, in this blessed night, and ask ourselves, do we in our actual life follow the footsteps of Fatima al-Zahra in our day-to-day life? We are the Shias of Fatima alayhi salam. Do we apply her religious principles in our day-to-day life? How beautiful it is and how nice it is that in the night of the birth of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, this night would be the night of the birth of all these good qualities that Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam represented. The birth of these qualities in our souls. What Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam wanted us to have and follow, to be born in this blessed night, the night of her wilada, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayha, as she was the lady of sacrifice for religion, the lady of affection, the lady of purity, the lady of hijab, the lady of generosity, the lady of sacrifices, and the lady of loyalty, and the lady of mercy. All these nice meanings were embodied in Fatima al-Zahra salawatullahi wa salamu alayha. Let's have a look at the life of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, at some lessons from the life of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, and implant it in our life. Inshallah, we start this by one loud salawat ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. The first lesson that we will take from Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, and inshallah I'll concentrate on this tonight, is that she is the lady of sacrifice for religion. Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam started her life defending the religion of Allah and defending Rasulullah from a very young age. She was the defender of Rasulullah. From the time she was 5 years old, she was defending Rasulullah from the mushrikeen of Mecca while they were putting that dirt on the back of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi, as our young angels told us the story. She was the one who was removing all that dirt from the back of Rasulullah and yelling and crying at those mushrikeen, how you dare do this for the Prophet of Allah? She will remove the thorns from the feet of Rasulullah. She will bandage those feet with all that mercy and affection from that young age. So he will call her Fatima Ummu Abiha. What does it mean, Fatima Ummu Abiha? Yes? Mother of her father, Ahsan Hajji, for his well-being, one loud salawat. From young age, she started defending religion of Allah. All the minutes of her life, all the moments of her life, till the end of her life, when she ended her life defending the religion of Allah and the Imam of her time, Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam. She remained in the service of Allah till she ended her life by martyrdom, defending Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam. All the minutes and moments of her life from beginning till end were in the service of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we are the followers, we are the lovers of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. The lovers of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam also and as well consider religion as the center of their life. As Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, religion was the center of her life. All her life revolved around the religion of Allah. If we are followers of Fatimah Zahra alayhi salam, all our life should revolve around the religion of Allah. Our religious principles should be the center of all our life. We should organize everything in our worldly matters, worldly affairs, according to our religious principles. Iman and religion is the center of everything in our life, and everything is revolving around this religion and around these religious principles. Religion for us, if we are followers of Fatimah al-Zahra, and today and tonight is her birthday, religion is not for us a partial, accessory, minor element in our life, where it can be like a dress. When it suits us, we wear the dress of religion. And when it doesn't suit our worldly affairs, we take off this dress of religion. It's not like that. As Fatimah al-Zahra alayhi salam sacrificed with all her life, all her body and soul for these principles, religions. I cannot come now and claim I am the follower of Fatimah al-Zahra and turn my back to all those sacrifices for of Fatimah al-Zahra alayhi salam and be religious whenever it's suitable for me and be irreligious when it doesn't suit me. This is not the role model of Fatimah al-Zahra salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayha. Inshallah, we are talking tonight about this great lesson, how to be like Fatimah al-Zahra in all your moments of your life, in all the days of your life, like Fatimah al-Zahra alayhi salam. Tonight I am in this center, this Islamic center. Alhamdulillah, I am religious. I came to the center, and alhamdulillah, I am participating in the wilada of Fatimah al-Zahra alayhi salam. Inshallah, I'll be like this tomorrow at work. I'll be like this after a few days in my cousin's wedding. I'll be like this, inshallah, in the holidays trip, and there are holidays coming. I'll be the same person because I am a follower of Fatimah al-Zahra alayhi salam. She made all the minutes of her life for the service of Allah. She was religious and she sacrificed for that till the end of her life. If I am a follower of Fatimah al-Zahra, I'll be religious in all these moments of my life. Sometimes you find someone, you come to him, you tell them that you look different today. Usually we see you, for example, in full hijab. Today you look different. They say, yes, but today is the wedding of my cousin. It is a special day, the wedding of my cousin. And when you tell him, why is that? He said, don't you hear the well-known prover? There is a proverb in Arabic, and it's very dangerous prover. Alhamdulillah, other communities, they don't have this prover. It's very dangerous and destructive. Don't you hear the prover? مَا بتسمع بالمثل سَاعَ إِلَكْ سَاعَ عَلَى رَبَّكْ. They say this. It's very dangerous. مخبرون. He is telling me not to tell other communities about this proverb. Actually, it's destroying and destructive for all the principles of your religion, because it actually means that half of your time is in the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And by this, you are destroying all the bases of your religion. And many people, unfortunately, it's still common in some of the communities. You see them in a certain sin. You tell them, dear brother, but this is not allowed by religion. Said, Sa'a ilak, Sa'a ala Rabbak. Very destructive. Very destructive. If you are a real follower of Fatimah al-Zahra alayhi salam, it will be Sa'a ala Rabbak, Sa'a ala Rabbak. All the minutes of your life, every and each second of your life and moment of your life is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She sacrificed for this religion to reach to us. If we are real followers of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, we should follow the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in each and every second of our life to be true followers. But if I follow this prover, and alhamdulillah other communities do not know this prover, I'll be picking whatever suits me. I'll pick it from religion and apply it, and whatever doesn't suit me, I'll leave it. And actually these people, such people, are suffering from something which is called a state of hesitation. They are suffering of condition of instability. They don't reach in all their life to that state of tranquility and tuma'nina and iman. And they will not reach. Because I'll give you, what will happen when you don't have this stability? What will happen when you have this instability? I'll give you this example. It's like an old building which has a very weak foundation. You cannot build on top of it. You cannot progress. You cannot have improvement in building your soul and building your spirit, because it's moving and shaking all the time. You have no progress on the spiritual side. And this is the best case, because when you have a shaking building, it may collapse at any minute. And this is the most dangerous thing. It may collapse at any minute. But if you take Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, and tonight is her birthday, as your role model, she sacrificed all the minutes of her life from beginning to ill till end in the service of Allah, you will have a stable building with very good strong foundation. When you have that building, you can build on top of it. One floor, two floors, three floors, you can progress. You can get near and near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, closer to Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam, and you will reach to that state of tranquility and tuma'nina. At that minute, you will reach to what they call happiness. And you will say, yes, this is what I was looking for all my life, to reach to this happiness. Every one of us is looking for this happiness and this tuma'nina and peace and tranquility. And if you follow the role model of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, and in all the minutes of your life you are a follower of Allah and follower of Ahlul Bayt, you will reach to that happiness and you will reach to that tuma'nina. As Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam sacrificed all her life for us, that this lesson reaches to us. When she is mentioned in her shahada or in her wilada, we learn from her. So we can tonight, in her birthday night, go out from this hall with this love and this lesson from Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, and make all the minutes of our life in the service of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As she sacrificed all her life, first, as an obedient and affectionate daughter, then as an ideal wife, then as a mu'mina, perfect mother, then as defender for religion, and last, as a martyr for true Islam. From the beginning till end, sacrifices all the minutes of her life. If we are true followers of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, all the minutes of our life should be obedience for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the first lesson. The second lesson we can take from Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, she is the real model for mothers. Sisters, may Allah reward you for your attendance. She is the best role model for motherhood. No mother can have that great motherhood like Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, when she raised her children with that iman and love and compassion, and she overwhelmed them with all that tenderness and affection. See how nice it is when Imam Hassan alayhi salam enters the house. Imam Hassan knocks the door, enters the house. He says, "Assalamu alayki, peace be upon you, dear mother." She says, "Wa alayka assalam, ya qurrat ayni wa thamarat fuadi." Peace be upon you, O light of my eyes and fruit of my heart. Imagine how beautiful. Fruit of my heart. Imagine, mothers, imagine that always in your house you have this beautiful language with your children. All this love and affection. How beautiful families we will have. Imam Hassan, Imam Hussein will learn from Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. Imam Hassan will wake up at the middle of night. He will be fascinated by the light of Fatima al-Zahra in her mihrab doing Salatul Layl. He will come near and near and learn from her khushu' and ruku' and sujood and qunut. He will have all that knowledge and he will have that submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that when he later, even before Salat, when he's only making wudu, he will be shivering and shaking. They will tell him, "Dear Imam, what is this? Why is all this shaking?" He will answer them, "Don't you know that I'm going to stand in front of all, in front of the creator of all the heavens and the earth, in front of Jabbar al-Samawati wal-Ard?" This is the school of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. Imam Hassan alayhi salam learned this from his mother Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, who is the ideal mother for all mothers. This Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, she will teach her children that respect for others, how to have respect for others, even respect for the feelings of others, especially those who are elder than us. Dear mothers, if you want to teach your children how to be respectful with others, go to the school of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. Imam Hassan is 7. Imam Hussein is only 6 years old. They are passing in one of the streets of Medina al-Munawwara. They'll see that old man making wudu. But unfortunately, he was not doing the wudu properly. So they want to tell him, but they've learned from Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam that he is older. We should not come to him directly and tell him, "You are doing wrong wudu." They are still young and he is very old. They should respect him. They are the children of Imam Ali, but he's an old man. They should respect him. And this is their cleverness. They thought about an idea. They are polite and clever at the same time. And this is how our children should be. And then they came to him and said, "Dear uncle, please be the judge between us. I am saying that I'm doing wudu in the best way. And my brother Hussein is saying he's doing wudu better than me." This old man accepted happily. He is the judge. He said, "Yes, please do wudu." Imam Hassan started. This old man was fascinated by the perfect wudu of Imam Hassan. Then Imam Hussein started. Then he was fascinated by the perfect wudu of Imam Hussein. Then he came to know that his own wudu was batil and he didn't know how to make wudu. He came to them and thanked them. "You taught me how to make wudu." This is the school of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. Allah salli ala. Another lesson we can take from Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, inshallah, it's the last one, as I've taken from you time. She is the lady of affection, Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. And this Salatul Layl that she will do, and Imam Hassan will come near to her and listen to her, he will hear her in her qunut from midnight till morning, making dua for all the poor and the needy and the neighbors, until her feet got swollen. And she will mention her own family at last. He will come to her, "Dear mother, why you mentioned everyone first? And when mentioned us, your own family, at last?" So she will teach Imam Hassan and she will teach us another lesson of affection and selflessness. She will tell him, dear Hassan, al-jar thumma ad-dar. First the others, the neighbors, then your own household. Before the night of her wedding, and this is a very good story for our sisters. Before the night of her wedding, Rasulullah entered her room. Tomorrow is her wedding. She will be married to alayhi salam. May Allah reward you for his blessed name and loud salawat. Actually, our leader, our Imam, Imam Ali alayhi salam, needs a much louder salawat. Rasulullah will enter her room before the night of her wedding. He will see that Fatima al-Zahra has only one old dress. And tomorrow is her wedding. Rasulullah went and brought her a new nice dress. He went away. After a few minutes, someone knocked the door. Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam came, opened the door. She saw a poor girl. She said, dear lady, do you have any dress for me? I am in this condition as you see. Said, yes, dear. Just wait a moment. I'll bring you a dress. She went inside. She has only two dresses. She wanted to give the old one, but she remembered that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, always give your best. And what was her best? A wedding dress. She got the old one for herself. And her only wedding dress, she gave it to that poor girl. She is teaching us, Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, this is the last lesson tonight. How to be affectionate, how to be selfless, and how to give priority to others over ourselves. We have such a great lady who is the great lady of all the women of the world, the lady of paradise and the mother of all our dear imams. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, please raise your hands for dua. By the blessing of Fatima al-Zahra, salawatullahi wa salamu alayha, by the blessing of this night of her blessed birthday, by her purity, by her sacrifices, by her affection, ya Allah, Allahumma inna nas'aluka, wa nad'uka, wa natawajjahu ilayk bi ahabbil khalqi ilayk, Muhammadin, wa Aliyin, wa Fatima, والحسن والحسين والأئمة المعصومين من ذرية الحسين بسيدتنا ومولاتنا سيدة نساء العالمين وأم الأئمة الميامين وشفيعة يوم الدين فاطمة الزهراء عليه السلام فرج عنا يا الله. اللهم عجل لوليك المهدي الفرج والعافية والنصر. اجعلنا من خير أنصاره وأعوانه والمستشهدين بين يديه. اللهم أرنا الطلعة البهية والغرة الرشيدة واكحل نواظرنا بنظرة منا إليه. اللهم عجل فرجه وسهل مخرجه وأوسع منهجه واسلك بنا محجته. اللهم من كان في مجلسنا هذا صاحب حاجة. Our dear brothers, our dear sisters, اللهم اقضي حوائجنا يسر أمورنا فرج همومنا وغمومنا شافي مرضانا بحق فاطمة الزهراء عليه السلام وولادتها. ارحم أمواتنا. إلى أرواحهم جميعا نهدي للجميع ثواب سورة المباركة الفاتحة تسبقها بأعلى أعلى أعلى أصواتكم صلوات.